ഹായ് ഓൾ, നമുക്കിന്ന് തേർഡ് മൊഡ്യൂളിൻ്റെ ലാസ്റ്റ് പാർട്ടാണ് ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യാനുള്ളത്. അതിൽ പറയുന്നത് യൂണിഫോം കൺവെർജൻസ് ആൻഡ് ഇൻ്റഗ്രേഷൻ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ ടോപ്പിക്കാണ്. ഈ ടോപ്പിക്ക് ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യുന്നതിന് മുന്നായിട്ട് നമ്മളൊരു റെഫറൻസ് ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് വാട്ട് വി കോൾ സ്റ്റോൺ വി എസ്ട്രാസ് തിയറം. ദിസ് എ ഫേമസ് തിയറം. ഫോർച്ചുനേറ്റ്ലി ഓർ അൺഫോർച്ചുനേറ്റ്ലി ദിസ് തിയറം ഇസ് നോട്ട് ഇൻക്ലൂഡഡ് ഇൻ യുവർ സിലബസ്, സോ യു നീഡ് നോട്ട് വറി അബൌട്ട് ദിസ്. ബട്ട് to justify the next sessions of this module, you need to refer this theorem. That is very important. Next theorem is next session is uniform convergence and differentiation. In the previous sessions, we have discussed continuity, integrability along with the uniform convergence. Those sessions, we have seen that if fn is a sequence of fn is a sequence of continuous functions, then its uniform limit, if we consider fn as a sequence of uniform sequence of continuous functions, then uniform limit of this fn, say f, okay, if this convergence is uniform, then if this is continuous, then f is continuous. Okay, next session we have shown that if fn are integrable functions, okay, and suppose or even still just integrable, and fn converges to some f uniformly, then we have shown that this is also integrable. So uniform limit of continuous functions continuous, uniform limit of integrable function is integrable. Okay, obviously in this section we will we need to discuss the uniform limit of differentiable functions. Okay, so what we have expected is in this session, if we consider a sequence of differentiable functions, so if we take differentiable functions and take the uniform limit, if this convergence is uniform, what we expect here, okay, we would expect this f is differentiable. Okay, if fn are all differentiable and f is uniform limit, then obviously we would expect this is to be a differentiable function. But this theorem shows that that is not possible. Okay, in general this is not true. Okay, we can never expect a smooth result from this differentiability. Okay, this is because just verify this theorem. This is the Strong-Weierstrass theorem, very famous theorem. If f is continuous complex function on AB, okay, for example, I take f of x equal to mod x on 0 minus 1 1. You know that this f of x is, obviously f is continuous, okay, continuous on minus 1 1. Then there exists a sequence of polynomials. Okay, so there is a sequence of polynomials, say Pn of x. Okay, so this is a sequence of polynomials such that limit n tends to infinity Pn of x converges to mod x, okay, uniformly on AB. So this is the Strong-Weierstrass theorem. If we in Strong-Weierstrass theorem we are considering complex functions, that's then we would expect this Pn of x is complex polynomials. If we consider or if we replace this complex function by a real function, you can expect this Pn is real. Okay, then since this mod x is a real continuous function on minus 1 1, then there exists sequence of polynomials, real polynomials. Okay, in this case we have real polynomials which uniformly converges to this mod x. Okay, that means there is a situation at which we can see Pn of x converges to mod x uniformly. Okay, then what do you think about the result what we have stated here? Okay, so this, since these are polynomials, these are differentiable functions, okay, and this convergence is uniform, okay, and limit function is this, but we know that this function is not differentiable at x equal to 0. In the domain x equal to 0 is a domain in this minus 1 1, so f of x is not a differentiable function. Okay, that means According to this Stone-Weierstrass theorem, there exists sequence of differentiable functions which uniformly converges to a non-differentiable function. Okay, that means this theorem or this result is generally not true. Okay, therefore, we can never expect such a theorem in this session. Okay, so what is the requirement of this type of convergence? That is discussed in this session. Okay, so if we consider a sequence of fn differentiable functions, if we what is the relation between the sequence of differentiable functions and uniform convergence? That is the main thing in this session. Okay, so if we consider differentiable function, sequence of differentiable function, okay, and suppose that fn dash, so the sequence of derivatives of these functions, and this converges to some function, say I'll call it as some g, converges to g uniformly. Okay, that means fn is a sequence of differential function. We never expect the convergence of this fn, but we are given that fn dash converges uniformly to some function g. Okay, in this case the convergence of this fn, sequence fn, okay, at some point x equal to x naught. Okay, if you take any if you take at least one point x naught from the domain such that sequence fn of x naught is convergent. Okay, these are the hypothesis of our next theorem. Fn is a sequence of differentiable function, and at one point that sequence is convergent. At one point we can expect this is a real sequence, say a1 a2 etc., a1 a2 a3 etc. Okay, and suppose that real sequence is convergent, that means fn converges. We never expect the point, even the point wise convergence of this fn. In order to get the point wise convergence of fn, we need to get, this is true for every x, but we expect or we take the convergence of this fn at least one point. Okay, so that means we are not expecting even point-wise convergence of this fn. Fn is a sequence of differentiable function. At one point it is convergent, the sequence is convergent, but another assumption is fn dash converges uniformly to g. Okay, in this case these hypotheses imply that, these three hypotheses imply that fn converges to f for some function f uniformly. Okay, if this is the case, then sequence of differential functions converges to a function f uniformly. Okay, this is the conclusion of these hypotheses. Okay, first hypothesis, differentiable function, sequence of differential function, at one point it converges, and its derivative, sequence of its derivatives, converges to some function g. Okay, then what is the conclusion? Fn converges to some function f uniformly, and fn dash converges to this g. G is nothing but this f dash. That means at this case we can expect fn dash converges to f dash, or this we can prove that this g is nothing but the derivative of this f. Okay, so if these three hypotheses are true, then we can say that fn converges to f and fn dash converges to f dash. Okay, this is the only case. So next we state the next theorem and we'll prove that theorem. Okay, that is theorem, that is theorem 7.17, and this is the statement of the theorem. Suppose fn, sequence fn, is a sequence of differentiable function on ab, and such that fn of x naught converges for some x naught belongs to closed interval ab, and if we have one more assumption, sequence fn dash that we have discussed earlier, sequence fn dash converges uniformly on ab to a function f. Okay, then we have sequence fn converges to a function f. Okay, so this is g. Our assumption is fn dash converges to a function g, then sequence fn converges uniformly to a function f, and limit n tends to infinity f n dash of x equal to f dash of x. Okay, so this is the situation at which we can expect the uniform limit of differentiable functions is differentiable. Okay, so I'll repeat the statement once again. Suppose sequence fn is a sequence of differentiable function on a b and such that fn of x naught converges for some x naught belongs to a b. Okay, so there exists at least one point at which the real sequence fn of x naught is convergent, and if we assume the uniform convergence of this fn dash, if fn dash converges uniformly on b to a function g, so you need not worry about this function. At last we can get this g is nothing but f dash, so you can remove this one. Then what is the conclusion? Then sequence fn converges uniformly to a function f, and the sequence of the derivatives of fn converges to the derivative of this f as well. So this f is we can get f is differentiable and fn dash converges to f dash. Okay, now we can prove this theorem. So for the proof, we have assumed that this fn of x naught is convergent. Okay, so for any epsilon greater than 0, we have epsilon by 2 is also greater than 0. Okay, then for every positive quantity this, there exists n such that n belongs to the natural numbers, such that this modulus of fn of x naught minus fm of x naught, this is the Cauchy criterion for convergence of a real sequence which is less than or equal to epsilon by 2 or less than epsilon by 2 for all n greater than or equal to n, for all m greater than or equal to n. Okay, so this is the case. So this is the this is by the convergence of this function at one point x naught. Okay, so we have chosen capital N such that n greater than n, m greater than or equal to n. We have modulus of this fn of x naught minus fm of x naught less than or equal to epsilon by 2. Okay, and now we have another assumption is the sequence fn dashes converges uniformly. Okay, so we write the Cauchy criterion for the convergence of fn dash. So what is that one? So first I'll put this is n1, and for the same epsilon by 2 we have, if epsilon is greater than 0, for the same epsilon we have epsilon by 2 times b minus a is also greater than 0. Okay, so corresponding to this positive quantity there exists some n2 belongs to n such that we have this is this fn dash is uniformly convergent. Then we have fn dash of t minus fm dash of t less than or equal to epsilon by 2 times b minus a. So this is the epsilon, instead of epsilon we have taken this one for all t in between a and b. Okay, so this is the uniform convergence of these fn dash. Okay, now if we choose maximum of this, if we choose n such that n is the maximum of n1 and n2, we can expect for every, so this is n1 and this is n1, so this is true for all n comma or n is greater than or equal to n2, m is greater than or equal to n2 again. So if you choose n such that n is the maximum of n1 and n2, then we can expect for that n these two conditions simultaneously hold. Okay, so now you can remove this n1 by n. Okay, so we can expect this is a common stage. Okay, if we choose the maximum of this, then for the same n we have this result. Okay, so corresponding to epsilon greater than 0, we can choose n such that these two conditions are true. Okay, so this is because of the assumptions fn of x naught is convergent and fn dash is uniformly convergent. Okay, now we discuss we will construct a new function f h is equal to fn minus fm. okay, we know that this fn minus fn is differentiable, fm is differentiable. Okay, if we choose any n and m after this stage capital N, we define h. Okay, then h is a differentiable function. Okay, let h be a differentiable function, be differentiable on AB. Okay, then we can apply the mean value theorem. Okay, what is the mean value theorem? H of x minus h of t divided by x minus t is equal to h dash of some point in between that x and t, then that is what we call that, I will call it some x dash of c in between this x and t. Okay, if we choose any x and t from that interval AB, we can expect this. Okay, so when we translate this or replace this h by this function, before that we can write it as this, as by taking moduli on both sides, we have modulus of h of x minus h of t, modulus of this is equal to modulus of h dash c into modulus of x minus t. Okay, and when we replace this h by this function, you can get fn of x minus fm of x. This is our h of x is fn minus f minus h of t. What is h of t? Fn of t minus fm of t. So we have plus fm of t here. Okay, and this is equal to modulus of fn dash of c minus f m dash of c, okay, into mod x minus t. But we know that fn dash of t minus f m dash of t is less than or equal to epsilon by 2 times b minus a for any t in between a and b. So we can replace this quantity with its bound epsilon by 2 times b minus a. So this is less than or equal to 2 epsilon by 2 times epsilon by 2 times b minus a into x minus t. But we know that x minus t, the distance between x and t is always less than or equal to distance between b minus a. So this quantity is always less than or equal to 1. So this is again less than or equal to epsilon by 2. Okay, but now we can write this as modulus of fn of x minus fm of x minus fn of t plus fm of t less than or equal to epsilon by 2. Okay, for any x comma t belongs to AB. Okay, so this is an important result. So please note this as equation number 1. I call it as equation number 1 for further reference. Okay, now we can prove the convergence of fn. For that we use the Cauchy criterion again, Cauchy criterion to prove the convergence of uniform convergence of this fn, sequence fn. Then for epsilon greater than 0, we have fn of x minus fm of x. We need to make this modulus is less than or equal to epsilon for any x, okay, respective of x from AB. So we write this as modulus of fn of x minus fm of x. I insert one quantity fn of x naught plus fm of x naught, and we add the same thing here, plus fn of x naught minus fm of x naught. Okay, so this can be by using the triangle inequality, this can be written as less than or equal to modulus of fn of x minus fm of x minus fn of x naught plus fm of x naught plus modulus of fn of x naught minus fm of x naught. Okay, but we know that this quantity is less than or equal to epsilon by 2 by 1. Okay, using this one, you can write this can be replaced by any x and t. So if you replace this t by x naught, then this quantity is less than or equal to epsilon by 2. And we already discussed this fn of x naught is convergent, and by Cauchy criteria, we have fn of x naught minus fm of x naught is also less than or equal to epsilon by 2. So we have this is also less than or equal to epsilon by 2, which is equal to epsilon. Okay, this is true for every x belongs to AB. Okay, which shows that fn sequence fn, this implies sequence fn converges uniformly. Okay, if this converges uniformly, then we can expect a function f. Okay, if n converges to some function f. Okay, next we will prove that we already know that this sequence of fn dash is uniformly converges to some function g. Now we will prove that this f dash is nothing but this g. Now we can replace this g by f dash. So this is, then we have limit and tension for the fn dash of x equal to f dash of x. Okay, so this is the next part of this theorem. To prove the other part, we fix an x. Okay, let we fix an x. Fix an x belongs to closed interval AB. Okay, now you define if t not equal to x. Define these functions first. We define phi n of t for t not equal to x. The phi n of t is equal to the function fn of t minus fn of x divided by t minus x. Okay, so this is the phi n of t, and this function is defined because t not equal to x, then that function is defined. And we define one more function phi of t is f of t minus f of x divided by t minus x. So these are two functions defined using an x. Okay, by fixing an x, then we define these functions. Okay, then what is limit t tends to x phi n of t? Okay, obviously we can take the limit on this side, then limit t tends to x fn of t minus fn of x divided by t minus x, that is nothing but fn dash x. We are given that fn is differentiable, but we are not aware of this this function. If we take limit t tends to x on this phi of t, if f is differentiable, then that will be f dash x. Okay, but we can assure that fn dash x is, because fn, we are given that fn is a differentiable function. So fn, this limit, limit t tends to x phi n of t exists, and that is fn dash x. Okay, now we will prove the uniform convergence of this phi n of t. Okay, for that we write what is phi n of t minus phi m of t. Okay, by definition, this is, what is the definition of phi n of t? That is fn of t minus fn of x divided by t minus x. So this is our phi n of t. What is phi m of t? That is fm of t minus fm of x divided by t minus x. Okay, so this is this modulus, and we rewrite this as modulus of fn of t minus fm of t, okay, minus fn of x plus fm of x. Okay, the rearranging the terms so because the denominator is common, so this is t minus x or x minus t. We write it as x mod x minus t. And this quantity, this quantity is nothing but we already discussed this quantity is less than we have written here. That quantity is always, this quantity is always less than or equal to. This is what we have obtained here. Okay, so this is the numerator. So this numerator can be replaced by less than or equal to epsilon by 2 times mod x minus t by b minus a. Okay, now we have, we can replace this by epsilon by 2 times b minus a into mod x minus t In do we have this denominator, that is 1 by mod x minus t. So denominator can be replaced by this quantity. Okay, now we rewrite or we using this fact, we can get this quantity, this by mod x minus t, that can be written as mod epsilon by this can be written as epsilon by 2 times b minus a. Okay, so that means modulus of phi n of t minus phi m of t can be made less than or equal to epsilon by 2 times this b minus a for any t belongs to a b with t not equal to x. Okay, that means this is true for every n greater than or equal to n and every m also greater than or equal to n, then we can get the uniform convergence of this phi n of t. Okay, so we can get using this argument, we can say that sequence phi n of t converges uniformly. Okay, uniformly. That means limit n tends to infinity phi n of t equal to this converges uniformly to a function. We know that at any point this phi n of t converges to this phi of t point wise. That means we know that limit by fixing some t naught, if t is equal to t naught, then phi n of t naught is equal to phi n of t naught is equal to limit, sorry, for f n of t naught minus f n of x divided by t naught minus x. So limit n tends to infinity phi n of t naught is nothing but by taking limit n tends to infinity phi n of t naught is this one, f n of t naught minus f n of x divided by t naught minus x. Okay, so we know that at if you fix one point this t naught, then we can get this is the this is t naught. So limit n tends to infinity, we know that this f n of t naught converges to f of t naught, this f of t naught minus, and this converges to f n of x, and this is t naught minus x, then you can get this is our phi of t naught. By definition, this is the definition of phi, f of t naught minus f of x divided by t naught minus x is phi of t naught. Okay, so if you fix a point t naught, this phi n of t naught converges to phi of t naught. That means phi n of any t converges to phi of t point wise. This is already this is just the consequence of the definition of phi n and phi. Okay, now here we can see this phi n of t converges uniformly, and this limit n tends infinity phi n of t is equal to phi of t, because the uniform this converges uniformly and point wise limit is phi of t. Okay, so this is the case. Now now we take limit t tends to x phi of t. Okay, what is this limit? Limit t tends to x phi of t is equal to limit t tends to x f of t minus f of x divided by t minus x. So we are observing the limit of this. Okay, so that is same as limit t tends to x phi of t. So that is limit t tends to x phi of t, and phi of t can be replaced by limit t limit n tends to infinity phi n of t. Okay, now this is equal to limit n tends to infinity limit t tends to x phi n of t. Okay, this is because we know that this phi n is a sequence of continuous functions and the convergence is uniform, so you can interchange these two limits. Okay, so that will give this one, that is limit n tends to infinity this one. Okay, limit t tends to x phi n of t. Okay, now this limit since we interchange this limit and take the first limit, limit t tends to x phi n of t. Okay, so that will give f n dash x. Okay, that we have already discussed. What is limit t tends to x phi n of t? Limit t tends to x phi n of t, instead of phi n of t we write limit this is limit t tends to x f n of t minus f n of x divided by t minus x. okay, and this is nothing but fn dash x. We already we are given that fn is differentiable, therefore this limit exists. Limit t tends to x phi n of t exists. Okay, so limit t tends to x phi n of t is equal to our fn dash x. But we know that this limit exists because we are given that this fn dash is converges, fn dash sequence of fn dash converges uniformly to some function, say g. Okay, we call it as some g of x. Okay. We have in the statement itself we have denoted this as our g of x. Okay, so in that case, so since this g of x exists, then LHS exists. That means limit t tends to x f of t minus f of x divided by t minus x exists. Okay, that means this is our derivative of this f. Okay, so what is left side? Left side is f dash x because the right hand side exists. So g f dash x equal to our g of x. What is g of x? That is limit n tends to infinity f n dash x. Okay, so this proves the theorem. Okay, f dash x equal to limit n tends to infinity f n dash x. In this case, the uniform in it with these hypotheses of this theorem, we can get a uniform limit of sequence of differentiable functions is differentiable. Okay, thank you. The next class we will discuss one of the important constructions called the construction of Noether differentiable function. So that is a nice construction in this real analysis. With that we can conclude module 3. Okay, the next class onwards we will discuss module 4, that is the last module of our syllabus. Okay, thank you.